for the lady, right? What's her name again? Clinton. I think that that's what's going to solve the issue. This is not solving the issue. And على الأسف الشديد, you have individual on the manabir campaigning on the minbar on Friday. Campaigning, أخي بارك الله فيك. Campaigning. Oh, you know what? This guy, he hates the Muslims. Let's all go vote for the lady. Campaigning, أخي, on the minbar upon batil, falsehood, being ignorant. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he refuted them. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alayhi sallahu bi a'lama bi shakirin. On Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, know best those who are the grateful one. This was when we mentioned about the three aspects of grateful. Yes, Yusuf. You got it? I'll repeat it. Yeah?
I got the first one.
Which one you got?
Be
grateful and Allah will increase you. Number three is call on Allah and Allah will answer you. وَإِذَا جَاءَكَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِآيَاتِنَا فَقُلْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ أَنَّهُ مَنْ عَمِلَ مِنْكُمْ سُوءًا بجهالة ثم تاب من بعده وأصلح فإنه غفور رحيم. سورة الأنعام verse number 53-54. وإذا جاءك الذين يؤمنون بآياتنا, when those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala verses, they come to you. When those who believe in the verses of Allah, they come to you. The ayat of how many types, Bilal? They are of how many types? The ayat. The ayat. No, I say when the word ayah, the word ayah, they are of how many types? Muhammad, the word ayah is of how many types? Right, ayah is a sign when you translate it in English, but I say how many types? Muhammad, 3.
Two.
Yusuf, 2. Say it.
Two.
I'm listening. Number one.
The one which is clear.
Kawniya wa shar'i. The universal signs and the
legislative
signs. Right? Wa min ayatihi ash-shamsu wal-qamar. لا تسجدوا للشمس ولا للقمر واسجدوا لله الذي خلقهن إن كنتم إياه تعبدون. طيب. So the ayat على قسمين of two types. The universal sign, let's say the ومن آياته الشمس والخمر والقمر, from the signs of Allah is the sun and the moon, and the نجوم, the شجر, the حجر, the بحر, you know, and the like. These are from the signs of Allah. They are the universal signs of Allah. طيب. And the other ayat are the legislative ayat, the Quran and the Sunnah. The Quran and the Hadith. Because the Hadith is al-masdar al-thani. It is the wahy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kadhalik. The wahy min Allah. So if they come to you, those who believe in our verses. So here he's talking about the verses ayat al Abdullah. Yes, the Quran and the Hadith. Yes, ahsanta. When they come to you, faqul salamun alaykum. Say salamun alaykum. Right? Peace unto you. Kataba rabbukum ala nafsihi rahmah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it upon him. Made it upon him. Because kataba mean what? Wajaba. Wajaba. Now there is another issue, inshallah ta'ala, I'm not going to take long, but we can deal with it next time. The wujub of Allah. in the wujub of the human being. Right? When we say the obligation, right? Kataba ala nafsihi, he had made it upon himself. Tayyib, he has made it upon himself. And when you say kutiba alaykum as-siyam, right? Same kataba. But here, barakallahu fikum, there is a two ways to understand both of this. We'll clarify it next time, inshallah. So he said, annahu man amila minkum, whoever among you do anything, bijahalatin, meaning anything from su, from sins, bijahalatin, out of ignorance, bijahalatin, out of ignorance. So here, likewise, bijahalatin, out of ignorance. It is an important point to understand this. That likewise, the ignorance here have also two meaning possible to it. Bijahalatin, being ignorant of the ruling, whether it is halal or haram, right? So he does it, but he didn't know what was the ruling. Or also the individual, he doesn't have full awareness of the implication of the sin, the punishment that is in regard to that sin. Bijahalatin, he doesn't know what is behind that sin. What is the punishment behind the sin? Right? So he did it also bijahala. He have committed this bijahala with having no knowledge of what is the implication of this sin. What could be the punishment of this sin? Tayyib. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, ثُمَّ تَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ, and he asked for forgiveness, or he repent after this, wa aslaha, and he do righteous actions. And he do righteous action, or he does righteous actions. And righteous actions must be what? Coupled with? Right, more in details. More in detail, the righteous actions, the condition of righteous actions. Al-ikhlas wal-mutaba'ah. Al-ikhlas wal-mutaba'ah, having sincerity and having what? To comply with the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Wa aslaha, and he have ikhlas, and he have what? Mutaba'ah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasalam. He let him know, فَإِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is of forgiven, of merciful. And this was Surah Al-An'am, verse number 35 to 45. Ma'zira. Verse number 53 to 54. فَمَنْ اتَّبَعَ الْحَقِّ, this is a very important point here. And whoever followed the truth, وَلَوْ كَانَ فَقِيرًا, and even if he is poor, even if he is poor, فَهُوَ الْكَرِيمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, he is the most noble with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's following the truth. He is the most noble with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَسْتَحِقُّ أَنْ يُقَابِلْ بالمقابلة الحسنة ويفسح له في المجلس. الله أكبر. And he is the one that we have to welcome with the best way possible. And he is the one that we're going to open, meaning give him a seat among us. You know, we're going to open up for him. We're going to get him seated, barakallahu fikum. We're going to make him feel comfortable in our mix. Because of what? Because that he has the truth with him. Because he has the truth with him. وَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنِ الْحَقِّ, and similarly, whoever turn away from the truth, he turn away from the truth, وَاسْتَكْبَرَ عَنْهُ, and he is belligerent in regard to the truth. He is yani, arrogant in regard to the truth. The شَهَفِذَهُ اللَّهِ say, فَهَذَا لَا يَسْتَحِقُّ وَهَذَا لَا يُسْتَحِقُّ التكريم, he is not being given no consideration. No consideration, no respect. That the likes of this guy, Moro Fati, we pass him by the street, akhi, la kalam, wala salam. He is not to be given no kalam or no salam. Limada, he is in opposition to the truth. Even if he is from our own country, even if he is from our own tribe, la kalam wala salam, because he is from the callers of ad-dalala. He is from the callers of ad-dalala. So he said, لِأَنَّهُ هُوَ الَّذِي أَهَانَ نَفْسَهُ. Why we don't give him no respect? Because he is the first one that disrespecting himself. He was the first one to disrespect himself. So therefore, فَيَسْتَحِقُّ الْإِبْعَادِ, that we must be far away, removed from him. Stay away from him and the likes of them. طيب, he say, وَالْإِقْصَى, and we got to exclude him. We will not allow him in our mix, barakallahu feekum. Not allow him in our mix. And likewise, barakallahu feekum, you have an individual you know of, and this is the thing that, alhamdulillah, we have to be strong, akhi, barakallahu feek. When certain things that we might know about one another, let us be firm in advising one another of those things. He cannot advise me of what he doesn't know about me. But if Abdullah, he knows it about me, akhi, it is for him to advise me in that regard. If Abu Khalid, he knows this about Abu Ibrahim, he got to advise him in that regard. He doesn't know about him, he can advise him in that regard. And it is not you got going after his issues, or you going after him, or you are his wakil or none like this. No. Al-Muslim, Akhul Muslim, the Muslim is a brother to a Muslim. Now I'm going to advise you whether now you're going to take it or you're going to leave me. As long as you're going to be around me, I'm going to advise you in that matter. I'm not going to be quiet about that issue. As long as, barakallahu feekum, you want to be around me, that this is in regard to what we all have to, alhamdulillah, advise one another. We can't be quiet about certain things. We will be like the Yahud. كانوا لا ينهون عن المنكر فعلوه. That they were not being, they will be quiet about the evil that they were doing one another. They were being quiet about the evil that they were doing. And alhamdulillah, all of us sitting here, some know some. Some know some. One know the other one. We might not all know one another in detail, but one know the other one. Because alhamdulillah, we all came, mashallah, some of us, we came to Salafia together. While we were doing our own dirt on the side. Right or wrong? No, let us not be faking the funk out. Straight up though. We came to Salafia together. So that means that we know what we were doing before. But if we want to now shovel the dust under the rug and be quiet about it, we will not, barakallah, be truly, truly up on that which is the truth. The Shahafidahullah Ta'ala, he finished with saying that it is incumbent to leave this individual alone. It is incumbent to stay away from this, like of the likes of this individual that turn away from the haq. And likewise to exclude them, barakallahu fikum, wal hijra, and to boycott them. And to boycott them. Now the boycotting is because of two reasons. Right, Adam? Number one, ahsanta, to show the individual that what he's doing is not right, to get him to realize that, listen, what you're doing is not right. Number two, to protect your own self, barakallahu fik, to protect your own self. Listen, I want to protect myself from this guy. Do I have that right? Right? I don't want to be what you call associated with this individual. Right? Now if they think, okay, they know that this individual, this is what he do. Now people might know it, but you might not know. Right? And now other people, they see you with him. They automatically associate you with him. They automatically associate you with him. Wrongfully or rightfully. And this was, barakallahu fim, the end point of the mas'ala number 101. So bi'idhnillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala, tomorrow, next week, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, if Allah give us life, we're going to be going over the mas'ala al-thaniya ba'da al-miyah, 102, which will be ihtimamu ahli al-iman fi niyatihim wa maqasidihim. They are